Welcome to the last unit in week 2. Units 1 to 4 of week 2 gave us the background of a typical online learning. In this unit, we shall be looking at how we can make our online learning more interesting and interactive. So let us move on to the last unit, Unit 5, Learning Devices. Learning devices help to bring interactivity into online course. There are 3 levels of learning devices: learner to content, learner to learner, and learner to teacher. The learners want to be able to interact with the content to gain understanding. The learner also want to be able to interact with co-learners who are not physically present. Finally, the learner wants to interact with the tutor or facilitator. The presence of this level of interactions help to mitigate distance between the learners and their tutors, as well as among the learners. Learning devices make the interactivity between learner and content effective. Learning devices help the learner to achieve the set learning outcomes and self-evaluate the level of learning attained. In Unit 3, we said access devices increases interactivity through easy navigation of content. But learning devices make the interactivity between the learner and content effective. Learning devices help the learner to achieve the set learning outcome and self-evaluate the level of learning attained. What are learning devices? Learning devices are the strategies deployed that help learners to easily assimilate content and apply what they learned. Examples of learning devices are formative assessments, such as in-test questions, self-assessment exercises, discussion forums, chats, hangouts, use of simulations, and illustrations. Access devices must be given a conscious place in an online learning with focus on the learning outcomes. Learning devices should be structured to enable the learners transfer the knowledge gained into real-life situation. The type of questions in formative assessment should be more of higher-order questions than low-order questions. The questions should be tailored towards problem-solving. Vary the types of learning activities used within course structures. In-test questions are the questions provided within the content to aid explanation of concepts. They are not meant for the students to answer. The course writer asks the questions and provides answers. In-test questions help to gain the attention of the learners in the content. Example of an in-test question. Let's assume you are writing for an online course on the topic balanced diet. The writer may say, "Why do we eat? We eat to live. To have a healthy living, we must eat right." This takes us to the topic balanced diet. What is balanced diet? In-test question help to create a flow in the content. Now, let us look at self-assessment exercises. There are different ways to present these to the learners. It could be drag and drop, multiple choice questions, etc. The purpose is that the learners should have the opportunity to assess how well he or she has mastered the knowledge received. In some instances, some people classify this as brainstorming. The name does not really matter. What matters most is that there must be provision within the content where the learners can assess their learning. Discussion forums are purposeful. There are 2 ways to this. You may design discussion forum for the learner to share their experience. Where this is the goal, you allow learners to create topic for discussion on the discussion forum. In this case, they have the opportunity to share experience and socialize. This type of discussion forum is usually not scoped. Anybody can come up with discussion topics. But where the discussion forum is geared towards academic achievement, it is only the content experts or the facilitator that will post the discussion topics. In this instance, the discussion forum may attract scouts. The facilitator must read discussion forum and weave the discussions. By weaving, it means summarizing the discussions, and this might lead to deriving new knowledge which the facilitator or mentor has to post for the view of all participants. The use of chats and hangouts are usually informal and provide community and social presence in an online course. The use of simulations and illustrations help to bring abstract into reality. This is very useful for the learner. We shall discuss more on this under week 4, applying OER for online learning. With this, we have come to the end of week 2. This week exposed us to the basics of online learning. Begin to apply what you have learned.